Here we go. Hello and welcome to the Misfit Show. Rated 5 stars. Didn't you know? It's Yarathar.
Yarathar.
Yarathar Yadav.
Hey, get a better name.
Yarathar Yadav.
Excuse me?
What?
I said get a better name.
Well, you don't like Yarathar Yadav?
It didn't go with the song.
Yarathar. Okay.
Well, they're verified on gamersubs.gg. They say, when I say I loved it, I mean I'm going to order it again and again. And again, what do you reckon about that? They love GamerSubs so much that they're just gonna keep ordering it.
Sounds like GamerSubs reviewers aren't funny, but the Misfits podcast listeners should fix that.
Sounds like GamerSubs actually just left that review under the fake name Yarathar Yadav.
Does sound like a fake name. Does sound like a fake name.
Allegedly.
No, GamerSubs is great, guys, and you can buy someone GamerSubs.gg using code Misfits. Look at that.
There's a new waifu drop. Look at that slut right there.
Why do you keep
Look at that slut right there.
All these sluts.
So many sluts.
So many dirty sluts that you could fill with GamerSubs powder energy.
So many keto-friendly sluts.
Everyone wants to fill up a slut and shake her up.
Move that up a little. There you go. Look at those milk. Do you think they produce some pre-mixed gamer subs right out the nips?
Those are some Misfits melons if I ever seen them.
Those are some Misfits melons right there.
Go to gamersubs.gg, use code Misfits for 10% off your order.
Get
of
the
gamer
best
energy.
Flavor. Get Misfits melon. It's good for
it's,
you.
It's
and
good,
good
it's
in general. Beautiful. Just fucking drink it.
We should get Mal on.
Who?
Mal.
Oh, Mal?
Yeah.
Gibson?
Yeah.
Mel Gibson?
Yeah, we should go.
Didn't
Mel.
He cheat
we
on
should
his
get
wife?
Mel on.
It wasn't the Passion of the Christ.
Yeah.
Some weird shit about him.
Incredible guy. I'm joined today by Mel Gibson.
I got it now.
Mel Gibson's here.
Hi. Something racist.
Mitt Creamy's here.
Something racist.
Swagger's here.
Something racist.
Matt's here on the bongos.
It's Bongo Matt.
Something racist.
Bongo Matt.
Racist Bongo Matt.
Fitz is here too.
And I'm here too. And Toby's here too. It wasn't actually Mel Gibson.
Yeah,
it's
I'm not
Toby.
Really Mel Gibson. No. I know it sounded realistic because I said something racist. But yeah.
Is Mel Gibson racist? Is this?
Didn't he say something bad about Jewish people?
I think it's anti-Semitic. I think he really hates the Jews.
But
and to be honest,
Jesus.
Like you know, I can really blame him for that because it's pretty awful.
Is that being
to
racist?
Hate Jews. It's
kind of racist.
I don't know if you could quantify it as a racial thing, but it's certainly bigoted.
Yeah.
Mel Gibson is certainly in the past bigoted.
But what did he actually say?
Yeah, are we like making this up? Is this
why a bit? We just going in on Mel Gibson at the beginning of a podcast?
He was just really passionate about Christ.
Right. Well, Christ was king of the Jews.
Oh.
So,
well,
I don't quite know why Mel Gibson
it's pretty
would be,
sick.
Maybe
he doesn't like them.
Maybe Mel wanted to be king.
Maybe. Maybe he did. Maybe Mel Gibson is the second coming of Christ. You ever think about that?
Yeah.
Wow.
I hope you guys are okay. What was the me and Mel are on first name basis. That's why I'm not saying Mel Gibson.
Mr. Gibson.
Yeah.
Right.
Mr. Gibson. Mel Gibson makes great guitars.
What does Mel wear?
I got a couple of those on my computer.
Yeah. Just a vague play on words.
Everything
there.
That Mel wears.
That took me so long to like catch up.
It's because you got antivirus software.
Yeah, I couldn't process it.
Didn't even get through the filter.
Yeah.
Did not even get there. What's going on, guys?
What's going on?
Yeah, well.
What's going on, guys?
5 cunts sit around a table for an hour. Welcome back.
It's just what we do.
It's what we do.
Well,
it's what we're known for.
Like me, Fitz, and Jay for the last couple of weeks have just kind of been chilling, doing our own thing. But what I'm more so interested in hearing is where Toby and Matt went off to.
Yeah.
Both separately.
What's going on?
Well, you guys think it was separate. We were having a secret rendezvous.
Secret romance.
Yes.
Wow. Romping around Australia.
Tell us about it.
Well, Matt and I, we decided to go on a trip to Uluru.
Uluru?
It's like a big table made out of a rock. In Australia.
What? Uluru. Yeah.
Is that the rock that's filled with air?
I don't know.
No, there's a lot of kangaroos there, though.
What?
Is that like...
I'm so lost.
Like, wait, is this real?
The airy rock?
Air's rock.
Air's rock. Yeah, the rock... That's the hollow in the middle filled with air.
Is that Uluru? Is that the same thing?
That's balloon. That's the empty earth theory.
I know nothing about Australia.
What? Wait, where'd you go? Please,
I didn't
please
go to Uluru.
This is all bullshit.
Matt wasn't there. I went to Perth.
You went to Perth?
Went to Perth.
Yeah,
that's
just
right.
To meet my girlfriend's parents.
How did that go? Nervous?
Not really.
No.
No.
Not a little bit?
No.
Not a little bit like, oh.
I'm very, very likable, you see.
If I was you, I'd be nervous.
Nah, I was a little nervous.
Yeah, understandable.
Yeah.
But they didn't notice all the flaws?
No, luckily. So that was good. I spent 3 weeks with them, living at their house.
Wow.
And you didn't show them a single one of your red flags?
No, I didn't pack those.
Oh, good. Smart.
Just leave them all behind.
Yeah, smart. Left the red flags at home. That? Yeah.
Mm.
But no, it was a good trip. We did some things. We went to a farm, guys.
A farm.
We went to a farm.
How exciting.
It was an animal farm.
Crops, too?
Yep, there were. Well, actually, no, there weren't crops. No. It was a tree farm.
Trees. Oh, tree farm.
Did you know that in Australia, I don't know if it's just in Western Australia, but the government will like pay people to plant seeds, to plant trees, and then just leave them on their land for 20 years, and then they come cut them down and pay them for it.
Wow.
And then they sell it to China.
Now I see what Mr. Beast was up to.
Yeah.
Oh, what the fuck?
Why?
That's right.
Fucking the Chinese and their fucking wood. You just can't get enough of the fucking wood.
Yeah.
What's wrong with them? Yeah. So much land.
It sounds like the best kind of...
They have their own trees.
Fucking Chinese.
They're fucking Chinese.
It sounds like the best kind of farming, though, because, like, what do you have to do to a tree?
Nothing. You just water it, you know, give it lots of love.
Mm, yeah. Sit under it.
So, like, you need to do nothing to a tree, really. Mm. And then after a few years, when you're counting up your stacks of cash, the government comes and chops them down for you.
How much money is it for a tree?
Yeah, what's it worth?
Well, they had a lot of trees, but they were making $10,000 a year from it.
From the trees?
From one tree?
Just from having it knocked
from all the trees.
Right.
So wait, they get...
Wait, that's a lot.
They wait 20 years and they get $10,000?
Yeah, so they get $10,000 every year for that entire 20 years.
That's 200K over 10 years.
That's a lot for like a few trees.
Just for having some fucking trees on your land.
Damn.
Shame.
How many trees, roughly, are we talking about?
At least 10.
Well...
Really?
That's quite a lot of trees.
There's a lot of trees.
It's like grand a tree.
It was
incredible.
There's a lot of trees. I don't know. I'm not good with.
Were they big, tall redwood trees, or were they just small trees?
They were pretty thin. I feel like big trees can't grow in Australia because it's such a shithole.
Yeah. No, I mean, no moisture.
Because it's so dry.
The ones that grow big burn down.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah.
But you know what I did to those trees? It was a bit of anarchy. Wanted to say fuck the government.
You carved your name? You carved your initials into it?
No, I shot them with a gun.
Oh my god.
Did you actually shot a gun?
I shot multiple guns.
What the fuck?
At a tree?
Yep. What guns?
Tree violence.
I shot a Winchester.
Nice, lever action.
Lever action. Mm-hmm. I shot a 308.
Uh-huh, pistol.
No.
Not the 308 pistol.
Yeah, it's a 38.
What's a 308? New Zealand.
308 is like a hunting round, like a large rifle round.
Yeah. And then just 22.
Uh-huh. So
but it was just shooting guns and looking at what we shot.
I'm jealous.
Shooting guns and watching trees grow, huh?
Yep, that was the life. Well, also they had motorbikes and go-karts.
That's fun.
So we were just riding go-karts around their property.
Sounds like you were just on Danny Duncan's ranch.
It was like a car engine on a frame, and it was just like it felt way too fast and extremely dangerous.
So like a
really
homemade go-kart?
Yeah.
Oh shit, that
it was really cool.
Nice. Did you shoot the guns while driving the carts?
I wish.
Like drive by.
That would have been sick.
And did you shoot the trees? Sick. I'm confused. What were you shooting?
Well, I shot a target that was on the trees.
Right.
So therefore, I was shooting the trees.
What was the target? Just a small boy? It was
a small child with a lollipop.
It was wrapped in a tree.
It was one of the sheep.
Oh, God.
Nailed it to a tree.
That's New Zealand. This is very offensive.
Nice,
there's three New Zealanders on the side of the table, and you're talking about murder.
It was an Australian farm, and they said, "You're from New Zealand, aren't you?"
Yeah.
And then they're like, "Well, have we got a surprise for you?" Lifted up a sheet behind a tree. Sheep.
Sheep. Lifted up a sheep, and behind which was a sheep.
Yeah. And they said, "You got to shoot this, otherwise you're not allowed to shoot the gun." And I said,
"You have to shoot the sheep under the sheet."
What'd the sheep do?
The sheep wasn't shorn.
shoot the sheep under the sheet?
Sheep!
Dude, that's wild. That's fucking crazy.
It was a lot of fun.
I've been trying to get my hands on a gun in Australia since I've been here to no avail.
For some reason,
we tried the black market.
I've been trying to get my hands on a gun in Australia since I spotted that sweet preschool down the street. Oh my god, this is just prime for it.
Oh, dude. Kids are so fucking awful.
True.
Kids are fucking awful.
Oh, the worst.
What sort of gun do you want?
Oh, to any. Literally any gun. I'll take a fucking brick action single shot shotgun.
Just become a farmer.
Become a farmer.
There you go.
Yeah.
Own some land. Some
I think Swagger would be a good farmer. Well, I don't know if he'd be good at farming, but I think he would make the part. fit the pot, you know?
Yeah, maybe when I retire, I might just move to Montana in the middle of nowhere, get a little lake cabin, get a farm, get a couple guns, shoot guns until I get bored. And then, you know, the guns will have another use for when I get really bored.
Just shoot yourself.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Incredible. Yeah. The life. The life.
The life.
The lives we live.
Yeah. Living the dream.
Living the dream.
Living the dream. No, I would never kill myself. Be a waste of ammunition. So expensive.
Yeah. That's fair.
That's fair. So expensive.
Respectful to the gun.
He said that the 308 shots we were shooting were $2 a bullet.
Yeah, yeah, they get a bad dad.
Is that expensive or is that cheap?
Well
for 308, I mean, it's like $10 to shoot a five shot.
Yeah,
but that's simple math.
Okay.
You buy those at the $2 shop?
Probably.
The $2
only
shop.
One.
Maybe in America.
Only one.
Only buy one.
One pack of 308.
Ammo is fucking ridiculously expensive.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Wow. And how would you know that?
I've shot guns.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
That's cool. What kind of guns have you shot?
P90 full auto.
How'd that make you feel?
Yeah, P90. It was fucking sick. It made me feel powerful.
You
strong,
just sprayed that.
Yeah, you sprayed the whole thing. It's weird. It's weird.
Right.
Which does that
also
cost to shoot? Jesus.
It cost me, it was like $500 at a range in Austin, Texas, but it was for a slew of guns. It was a P90 full auto, 50 rounds. It was a Galil, shot a Galil, which was fucking sick. I think that was chambered in 308. Or 7.62 or whatever it was. Shot a CZ-75.
Oh, you like? I've always wanted that.
Not
one.
Full auto, which sucks.
Yeah.
Shot an elephant rifle, which is pretty cool.
You shot an elephant?
Yeah. No, it was just a rifle. It was like a 45-70.
Okay. Made out of an elephant.
Yeah, it was complete ivory. It was the tusks of the white African rhino.
Oh, that's beautiful. Yeah.
That'd be a really nice looking gun.
Yeah, it was beautiful. It was great. It fucking blew up in one shot, but, you know, it was for the spectacle.
Worth it.
Worth killing an endangered white rhinoceros over.
Yeah, and when you shoot it, not only does the bullet come out, but the shrapnel from the ivory exploding.
Yeah.
Wow, guns are cool.
Guns are really fucking cool.
Sorry.
You know how I said that I left all my red flags at home?
Yeah.
That's a lie.
Oh, really?
Oh, plot twist.
I brought one red flag. It said it wasn't red, it was pink.
Oh.
I left it. We brought a little pink flag along with us.
Just literally?
No. We had something that was under our bed.
Oh, yeah. What happened?
And for anyone that doesn't know, my girlfriend and I have a little dog. And we brought him with us on the trip. And I was just lying in our bedroom one day. Mm-hmm. Teddy came in, walked out, didn't really watch him walk out, just saw him come in. And then like 5 minutes later, I saw my girlfriend walk into my room holding Teddy under her arm. And Teddy had our vibrator in her mouth, in his mouth. And he had just run into the living room where Elisa's entire family was. And they all had to work together to chase him and grab it so that they could get the vibrator out of his mouth.
Sounds like straight out of a movie.
Was it vibrating in his mouth?
No, I wish it was. Although we did get to the airport yesterday and Elisa was like, what's wrong with my suitcase? And it was vibrating.
Yeah.
It's like 50 vibrators in there. It's just the vibrator suitcase. Oh, it is going off. Set up a chain reaction.
But yeah, that was interesting. It was funny. Luckily, her parents aren't super conservative, so it was okay, but it was like, you know.
Can you imagine that happening and the parents being like, you have what?
What the fuck is that?
I feel like a lot of parents would have been very upset.
You reckon?
Why?
Maybe.
It's so weird.
I don't know.
That's cringe, dude. I mean, I can understand being a little embarrassed and not knowing how to act, maybe, if you don't talk about sex with your kids.
There's my daughter's vibrator. Whoops. We'd have to have a talk. Nobody fucking does that.
You can't be using these vibrators. It's not God's way.
Yeah.
Africans can be eating that vibrator. This is so wasteful.
That is true.
Yeah.
That's what parents do. Don't eat your vegetables. And, you know, poor little African boy could eat this. And it's like, Mom, we're not in Africa. You want to mail it? You want to mail these fucking peas to Africa? Have your parents ever said that when you're like eating food?
I'm just trying to imagine like a African child crunching down a vibrator. Well, maybe some lube to make it go down.
Receiving some peas in the mail.
Get some flavored lube.
Some peas.
Not the salty caramel though.
Have you guys ever tasted flavored lube?
Mason has. He talked about it last episode during his vlog when he went to Sydney. Him, his girlfriend Kobe, and his girlfriend's roommate, they all taste tested. Fucking lube.
I wonder what kind of lube it was, because there's like the lube they sell at supermarkets, and those flavors are gross because they're so sweet.
Right.
But I've tasted some like really nice lube. Sure. And it's like, some of the lube tastes so good that you just want to drink it.
Why can I imagine Toby in a wine in a suit with a wine glass swirling around the lube, maybe the aerate?
Yeah, that's exactly what happened.
Yeah, I tasted steak lube the other day.
Steak
really?
Lube?
Yeah, it was
steak
delicious.
Lube. Like steak flavored lube?
Yeah, steak flavored lube. Yeah, delicious.
Oh my God. Where'd you taste that?
Just at home. Just bought something in the supermarket.
Was it just steak blood?
Yeah, it was just steak blood.
Yeah, makes sense.
Oh my God, that's hilarious.
But speaking of sex toys and sex shops and that sort of stuff.
Yeah.
Another thing we did in Perth was we were driving around and I saw something that said $2 peep show. And I was like, well, this
a peep show for $2.
I wonder what the peep shows are. Like, what do you do? And Elise was like, well, I don't know. I think it's just you go in there, you pay $2 and someone flashes you their junk. Mm-hmm. And I was like, oh, interesting. And then we decided, you know what? It'll make a good story.
How much money do you have, honey?
Let's go and
$4.
So Elise and I both got our $2 coins. Yeah. We walked into the sex shop and we said, one peep show, please.
You inserted it into the cleavage?
Well, what happens is you walk into this back room. There's multiple cubicles. You walk in, you close the door, and there's just one of those like vending machine coin things. And it's a frosted window in front of you. And you have only one person can be in there at a time in each of the cubicles.
Right.
And the cubicles surround this big room in the middle.
Mm.
And you put your coin in, and the glass defrosts. And then all of a sudden,
interesting.
What I saw was, it was like a bedroom. It was like an e-girl's bedroom, like lots of like neon light sort of vibes.
Right.
Mm.
And there was just a bed in the middle.
Just a Twitch streamer just doing a high
class. He's like, what the fuck are you doing? What is it?
Who let you in here?
And there was two women laying on this bed. You put the coin in, they suddenly go, oh, someone's here. Yeah, you know.
Someone's peeping.
And they come up and they start dancing for you. They
so strange.
They twerk their ass for you and stuff.
What
and because
fuck?
Elise and I were in separate cubicles, one went up to me, one went up to Elise. And then we kind of walked out and we're like, that was weird.
It does sound weird.
But
it was in there all day.
But the weirdest thing, well, the woman said, we were like, how does it work? And the woman was like, well, you put your coin in and then it defrosts and you can see. And then it lasts 60 seconds. And then you put more coins in, and the more coins you put in, the more clothes they take off.
Okay.
But they started in their underwear. So, like, you can't really further it that much.
Mm. Maybe they've just got layers of tape.
Yeah.
Just peel off. What if you just go in with a stack of $2 coins?
Can you imagine? You really have a stack of $2 coins. They're sitting there. You're putting it. They take off their bra, and then there's like tape. And then you put it in, and they rip off the tape, and there's another layer. You put another one in, and it's like 10 layers of duct tape over their nipples. That'd
they
be amazing.
It's like getting nervous after 100 layers, and they start like, there's not much left. And then they just have to start like ripping off their actual skin.
$800 in.
Please, aren't you satisfied?
But it was so weird, and it was kind of uncomfortable because they can see you. So the glass defrosts, it defrosts for both. So they walk up and they're like looking at you, and you're kind of just standing there like, what do I do?
It's almost like you're the one being looked at. You
so
know,
like,
the one being spectated.
I was just standing there and I was like, what do I, like, I don't want to laugh. I don't want to, you know. I don't know. So I just kind of stood there. And then
you did what came naturally to you, was make them not feel so left out. So you started taking off your clothes
naturally,
as well.
Beautiful, beautiful.
But it, like, I don't know, like 10 seconds in, I was kind of like, well, I've seen it. Like, I know what it is now. Now I'm just kind of standing here for 50 seconds watching this thing that I don't really want to watch anymore.
Yeah. That was my experience when I got a lap dance once.
Yeah.
I was like,
yeah,
it was a private lap dance. And I was just like, yeah, after 20 seconds, the novelty just wore off, and I just felt uncomfortable. I was like, I just feel bad for you. Like, I know that you'd probably fine doing this, but like, I just feel uncomfortable. It's just strange.
Just had a conversation with her.
It's like not attractive to me at all.
But so, have you invested in Dogecoin? See a stripper?
Oh, I see you bleached your asshole. That's good for you.
Good for you.
Nice.
Yeah, here Ethereum's
what was the
going up.
Yeah. Just start talking about
fucking
crypto. Fucking, oh my God.
But when we left,
buy yourself a Bitcoin.
get yourself 0.0001% Bitcoin. You look a little bit too wet. Let me just dry you up. Just talk to you about fucking cryptocurrency for 30 minutes.
When we left, Elise was like, oh, that was so weird. And I was like, yeah, it was so strange. And then Elise was like, do you think people go in there and masturbate? And I was like, I mean, I guess probably.
Are you allowed?
And then she said, yeah, because there was a tissue this dispenser in my cubicle. And I was like, what?
You should ask us for COVID.
Like, I clearly didn't look around the room, but apparently there was tissue dispensers. Yes, just in case you need to blow your nose.
Just in case you need to blow your
nose. Or blow your load.
Yeah, blow your load.
Yeah.
Incredible.
COVID is found in semen.
Wow.
It was so strange.
It's an STD.
I wonder if there's like a peep show, but instead of it being like a 60-second thing, you basically just get to like spectate someone's room like that while they ignore you for 5 hours. Ugh. But they're kind of naked and like pretending like they're doing their own thing.
5 hours.
You know?
Sounds like, well, you know.
Or, yeah, or maybe not 5 hours.
Is that just maybe that's too
long? This is how long I would personally want if I was going to be doing something like this.
You know what was interesting about the peep show? It felt like watching a cam girl, but in person.
Yeah. And she could see you.
It was like a zoo animal.
Right.
And you can't even pet it. What's the point?
I paid money. I walked in there, looked through some glass, and saw some chicks dancing on a bed.
There's a bag of peanuts to throw at him.
Dude, I would totally go to a fucking strip club if it was themed like that.
Oh my god.
I could just throw peanuts and stop throwing dancing the shit at women.
Oh my god. I feel like that's how it used to be in the old days. It used to be much more of a freak show kind of vibe as opposed to like a classy establishment where the girls are treated well.
Look at the woman with the bearded lady and the fat ass.
Well, you know what I mean.
You guys have been to strip clubs, right?
Yeah. Of course
so
we have.
Yeah. The strip clubs you guys have been to, did you just give the strippers cash? Or did you have to buy like a special like stripper cash?
I paid with
stripper coin.
No, we did have there was stripper cash, remember? Or was that like an ad we had? It looked like a $100 bill and it had the name on it.
I think it was an ad. It was like ad. So they gave us like a little pamphlet there. Because we went to that one place in New Zealand.
Yeah, yeah.
And then that was what they did. That was the stripper cash thing. One that we went to in New Zealand was like, you know, you get fucking American money. It was like American themed. I don't know if we should say the name.
I heard the...
No free promo. No free clout.
Someone told me the other day, I was talking about strip clubs, and they said that the ones that they've been to in Australia, you aren't allowed to give the strippers cash. You have to buy these stripper cash and then give them that
strip coin
because and apparently it's because they said it's like dirty to put cash in there.
It is. It's
which makes sense.
Money is so dirty.
Oh,
like literally dirty.
Literally filthy.
Exchange
like,
many hands.
That the point? Oh, that's dirty.
It's
literally unsanitary.
Yeah, dirty, it's unsanitary money. It's not like dirty money, like through crime or whatever.
Oh, they're not
but
laundering it? Oh, shit. Yeah. There goes my plan.
You could poison a bill and then stick it in a coochie.
I don't even think the bravest woman would allow a dollar note to be slipped.
Well, maybe not a dollar.
What if it's $100?
What if it's $100?
Yeah. I think it's definitely been done before.
$100 bill into the cooch.
You'd have to leave a little bit dangling out, otherwise you couldn't get it out.
Yeah,
later.
But it'd be like, what do you think? Like, what about a paper cut? Any of that? I'd be
like
so scared.
Like it's plastic. Well, I guess in America it's kind of. Is it paper? Is it made out of paper?
It's cotton. Cloth.
It's made out of cotton.
Is it actually?
Oh, is it really? I didn't know that.
Curious.
Cotton fiber.
When are they going to change to hemp?
Of course, America uses cotton for
legal?
Their money.
Hemp money.
Respecting the heritage.
Awful.
Oh my god.
Awful.
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 Yeah, money's a funny thing. Exchanging hands, you can buy all kinds of things, including peep shows.
Or
GamerSubs.
Crazy,
$2.
Or GamerSubs, which we've already plugged, but go to GamerSubs.gg.
Get the GamerSubs lube flavor.
I mean, they don't need to make it. You need to just put GamerSubs in lube and mix it around.
Do you think that when they're making lube flavors that they have like people that come in and taste test it in, like little jars?
Hopefully
like,
they don't come in it.
Come in
it. They swish it around their mouth.
And spit it back out of the bottle and go, this'll do.
That's good. That was quite good. Quite delicious.
I want to be a lube tester.
Yeah?
Wait,
lube's gross, though. It's all sticky.
Guarantee that.
You squirt it on your hand first, and then you do what you need to do, and then it's like, well, now I've just got lubey hands.
Yeah, it kind of congeals
it's
after
like,
a time.
It's like, I don't want to touch the woman while I've got lube all over my
hands. Are you a water or an oil-based lubester?
I bought lube recently.
Really?
That was made by someone that used to work for NASA.
Wow.
Yeah.
It's like zero G
engineered.
And, and we got motherfuckers still saying,
there's no reason to go to the moon. There's no reason to go to Mars.
Space moon.
Because
all the
shit that we've done like in research and development to get to that point, lube.
Yeah, exactly.
That's the
fucking
one.
Lube. Also like memory foam and GPS and all that other boring, stupid shit that doesn't matter. But
memory
lube.
Foam was a byproduct of space travel?
Yeah.
How so?
No, it was used for some shit.
Is this the, I don't know. I don't remember. The phone does.
Guess, or did they make memory phones or seats or something?
I'm not sure. All I know is that the research and development they put in, there was like a huge list of inventions that if we didn't go to the moon or do anything space related in the 60s and 70s, then we wouldn't have. And I think under that was like memory foam. So like, you know, fucking Tempur-Pedic, you know, kind of shit where you're lying down on a...
The moon is made of memory foam.
Interesting.
That's why they went there to harvest
it. Actually made of cheese.
On it.
That's Russian disinformation. It's made of cheese.
Oh, it's made of cheese. Grumble, right.
Yeah, they were.
Yeah.
Incredible. I wonder if there are like crazy space drugs out there. You know, on
different
planets, different compounds that we haven't discovered yet. That was
space weed.
Space weed.
Growing weed on Mars. Growing weed on Mars would be fucking huge. Mm. Would be so huge.
Why?
Yeah, it's just space weed. It's literally Martian weed. Literally Martian weed. You wouldn't smoke Martian weed. It'd be the most expensive midi shit that you could possibly get.
No, it wouldn't be.
And it'd be all shit and not fresh.
It'd be awful. 6 months in a... Well, what if it's stored like in an airlock with no air in it? Yeah. And then it's like, it doesn't even degrade.
Wait, if something's in an airlock, it doesn't degrade?
Well, like if all the air is sucked out.
Really?
Because how do things degrade in the first place? Is that only because there's a bunch of fucking shit bouncing around in the...
Like, say you had an apple, and then, like, you slowly decompressed all the air out of the room, and the apple was in a vacuum. Mm. Like, how is it going to rot?
Yeah, but wouldn't that also suck all the moisture out of the apple?
Well, if you want to be scientific about it. Then you get a nice, dehydrated, yummy apple.
Yeah. Mm. Like apple crisps.
Yeah. Put a whole apple.
Space apple.
Just, you're pretty much you'd be biting into a sponge.
It would be like, you know, when some people, they make like decorative fruit baskets, so they get those apples made out of like styrofoam.
Yeah.
Yes.
It would be like eating and like chewing into one of those as if it's got a little bit of flavor.
You know, at the TwitchCon party, there was a Roblox YouTuber who I met, became friends with that night, and he got so fucking drunk and also so high that he got really hungry. And in that Airbnb we were staying at, there was a bunch of, you know, like fake apples and pears. Right. And this guy just started biting into the styrofoam apple.
And if you're
apple.
Really fucked up, you probably don't notice it doesn't taste like apple.
No, shit. He was just biting into it, just eating just the styrofoam.
The
literally eating styrofoam. No, and he got through half of it when I looked at him. I was like, what are you eating? And he's like, oh, I'm having an apple. I was like, there was literally a metal ball for the core that he was like chewing on and trying to like bite into.
He's probably doing it for the bit.
I maybe he was drunk enough. He thought he was funny, but like, I wouldn't literally swallow half an apple's worth of styrofoam for a bit.
Mm. I saw this video of this guy eating styrofoam. He took a bite out of a styrofoam apple, then a bite out of another one, and then on the third one, he took a bite and it was a glass apple, and it just exploded.
What? Like a solid glass one, or like a hollow one?
Like hollow.
Oh my god! He just took a bite of that shit.
Awful.
Yeah. Cut his mouth.
Just took a little nibble.
Dude, it is bad awful. Enough to eat a fucking Dorito the wrong way and have it cut up like the barrier between your teeth and your gums. Imagine that with glass. Mm. A glass shard going in between your front tooth and your gum.
No, way up there.
Yeah,
glass
the reason.
Choke on the chip.
When you swallow, have you guys ever swallowed a Doritos whole and it just fucking slices down your esophagus all the way down? I've had it happen before, dude. When I was like 8 years old, I swallowed a Doritos. We had like a family gathering. And I was crying for like 2 hours. So how much it hurt.
It's pointy. It's pointy on the inside.
I was like fucking spitting blood or something because of just all the coughing it up.
Traumatic.
Yeah, it was pretty bad.
You know what's crazy is Jay linked me this thing the other day. It's the Dark Side of Oz.
Yeah.
Which is, you might have heard of it. It's a pretty well-known urban legend I've discovered, but I hadn't heard about it until recently. But it's like, if you sync up Pink Floyd's The Dark Side of the Moon with the third roar of the beginning of like what's the intro?
1939 Wizard of Oz.
Yeah, like what's the lion though at the beginning? It's like the MGM. What's that company
called?
Yeah,
I think it is the MGM one. The
MGM intro, you know, with the lion. Yeah. If you sync it up on the third roar, then like the entire album syncs up crazy coincidentally with the movie The Wizard of Oz.
It's scary. It's so
like,
scary.
There's all these, I don't know, like the movie just seems to flow with it, and like there's times where the character's lips are moving and they're saying the lyrics, or like a heartbeat's playing and it's the Tin Man talking about how he doesn't have a heart, and like all these crazy coincidences. It's apparently a phenomenon that people have been sort of getting high and experiencing since way back when. But it also caused me to look into The Wizard of Oz, the old movie. Apparently fucked up shit was happening behind the scenes when they were filming that film. Like all the snow they used was actually asbestos and like the actors were treated terribly. And all the little
The munchkins.
The munchkins were just terrible, like little drunks that like some sexual abuse happened with those guys, and like they would just get drunk every night molest people and just be like belligerent as fuck. One of them, like those guys, they only died recently, those little munchkin guys.
They're still
famous to this day. Like I looked them up. This like little munchkin guy looked like an 80-year-old man now.
A dwarf.
Yeah. Well, he wasn't. I never actually was a dwarf. I don't actually know if
they would all be dwarves. They were all dwarves back then. No, I think they didn't have special effects.
I think it was mad short. I don't know if they actually had like the dwarf gene. Maybe they did, and I'm just ignorant.
Would be like below 4 foot. It's like below 4 foot two.
Here's the thing: like that. Can you just be mad short without being a dwarf?
Well, no. Look at the old Wizard of Oz. They got the legs that are shorter than the torso. And
yeah, but like maybe they're just mad short. That's what I'm saying.
Yeah, maybe
like,
they're just like maybe,
I don't want to use the word midget.
But you'll use the word munchkin.
There are called munchkins in the movie.
Munchkin sounds cute.
But you know, like, isn't the dwarf like a genetic thing? Yeah. What if you're just crazy short? Also, what if like you're just a little, your parents just raised you like a bonsai tree. They put wires on you that stunted your growth.
Bonsai tree.
It has made you like a little small human.
Yeah, well,
stunted your growth.
You know,
does that make you a dwarf?
You know how in China,
something to think about. I don't know.
You know how in China, there was a thing where it was seen as desirable to have small feet.
Chinese foot binding.
Yeah, so they would bind their feet so their feet couldn't grow any bigger. Yeah.
Smaller.
You could do that.
So fucked.
Back in the olden days, and you know, old China. They had, you know, like this huge cultural thing where, like, women's feet, if they're small, then that means, you know, whatever the fuck.
They're very sexy.
The foot fetish has been around for ages, clearly.
And so, like, they had these women's feet. They'd literally fucking, like, wrap it up, like, super, super tight, and they'd put it in, like, super tight shoes that they'd never take off. And then, like, you see, like, you know, like, these black and white photos of, like, these old Chinese women.
Their toes are curled under.
They're, like, completely... It looks like it's broken and deformed.
Oh, my God.
Did you see those African tribes where they do the opposite? They make people taller? They put, like, rings around
neck extension.
You look like the dudes from Star Wars, like the Kaminoans or whatever, with the cloning thing. Remember the tall-ass necks?
Oh, yeah.
That shit is interesting. That shit is really interesting. Wait, like, you know, all I'm saying is, can you just raise a little bonsai human?
Well, think about it.
Sure you can.
think about it.
A little like body cast that like restricts his growth.
Just gotta trim him every time he grows.
And like they don't look quite like a dwarf, but they're just very small.
Very small.
Like imagine me, but I'm just like small.
Have you ever seen those fruits where they grow an apple inside a glass shell that's in a shape? And then you get a square apple.
Well, like doing glass watermelons and shit.
No, I'm just saying, you could do that with a human.
Like a
their heads are like really soft when they're young. What if you put a big thing around its head and like in a few years it looks like some like Alien versus Predator shit?
Baby head like putty. You mold that shit.
It's such a shame that it's considered cruel to experiment with these kinds of things. You know, I think we should be trying this.
Children should be experimented on because they don't remember shit.
There should be 500 kids every year. In every country.
Can we create a bonsai human?
That it is like experimented on in weird ways.
Yeah.
Throw a kid in a pitch black room for 20 years, see what happens.
Yeah, like if I sewed on someone else's foot.
It's fucking Batman when he emerges.
If I sewed on a fresh foot, like I cut off someone's foot, sewed it onto another person, would it then form into their body part?
What's his name? Mangala. That's what Mangala was trying to do. Old mate Mangala.
Who the fuck is Mangala?
Yeah, you know,
sounds like an alien overlord.
From Auschwitz, he was the dude that was like, you see these little twinsies here, these two little besties. Yeah, we're gonna take them, and then we're gonna cut off one's arm and sew it onto the other's torso and see what happens.
Like a mad scientist sort of character.
Oh yeah.
Well, what happened?
Nazi scientist.
Oh well, he got away. Right? You know, people saw his experiments. He were like, this is all really interesting, but this is also kind of unethical, don't you think? And he was like, 9, and then he left.
Well,
he was fucking, he did not appreciate
my experience.
Yeah, he went to Venezuela, and then he's fucking chilled there.
But what happened?
Or Argentina, or whatever. What do you mean, what
did
happened?
Anything happen? Did they?
No, they were all unsuccessful. Yeah. All those experiments didn't work. He just tortured people.
It's not very interesting, then.
That's kind of interesting.
It was the It was the Japanese in World War II. All their experiments against POWs, like, well, what happens if we put a guy in a room that's like negative 30 C for like, yeah, how long will it take him to die? They write that down. How long will it take if we cut off somebody's arm? How long will it take to blah blah blah? They do all these experiments, torturing and murdering people. Mm. And to my recollection, I think they were all tried, and then in exchange for all of their research that had plenty of like real useful information, in exchange for all of that like research, they like let him go. They
let the scientists go.
Yeah.
I mean, technically, you wouldn't need to do it again if you tried it. Like, you'd know what the outcome is.
But I thought that's the point of science, is it's supposed to be repeatable and testable.
Well, that's the thing. It wasn't really repeatable and testable, but they did it so much.
Just because they're pussies and they don't want to try
shit was fucked up. Like, that's what else is there to say about it? It's like, didn't work. Don't know why we expected. End of story.
It didn't work. Was kind of funny, but.
I bet those scientists have small testicles.
Small testicles? Mm. What does that mean?
I don't know. They were the same testicle and it sounded like testicle.
Yeah, it was a reach, but also pretty good.
I don't know. I just found it funny.
Testable.
This is a funny word.
This is detestable.
Fuck my fucking testicles.
Oh, God.
Matt, where have you been?
I just took like a week off just from work because it's been like, I think I told the story, I was like moving out of home and everything. And I was just like, 3 months later, I'm like, oh, hey, I haven't like gone anywhere or done anything, like take any days off. So I just took a week off, went up to Gold Coast.
Where? Yeah.
Did you drive up there?
No, I just flew up.
Nice. Nice.
I wanted to drive up and take a road trip, but it was like, it's like 17 and a half hours. Yeah. So it's like a 2 hour flight, which is $200.
Yeah,
and cheaper than
easy.
Petrol
that's
and
super
hotels.
Easy.
So I was like, yeah, nah.
Good time. Was it sunny?
It was, but I was let down. Like they talked about all the beaches being great and shit, but like, they're just normal beaches. They're not gold at all.
It's very...
There's no gold? There's no gold on the coast?
I bought a metal detector and everything. I go there. It's just a normal beach.
Out there by the fucking
I just found a bunch of beer
panning.
Caps. Like, yeah.
Where the fuck is it going,
Why aren't you guys looking?
Everyone's just relaxing.
This is all fucking pyrite. This is the fool's gold coast.
Well, Australia had a very big gold rush. I wonder if the Gold Coast does have anything to do with gold.
I'm sure you could look it up if you gave enough of a fuck.
I don't.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
You guys know anyone like in your family just has a bunch of gold?
Yep.
Yeah?
Nope.
Yeah.
What, like invested in gold?
Yeah. Because
I wanted to invest in gold when I was younger.
Yeah, like 5 years ago, so one of my relatives was like, buy gold now. And I was like, why did he like, buy gold, put all your money in gold?
It's an old crackhead.
It's like, Barrett.
Yeah.
It's all about the bullion, dude. It's all about, if you're not 60 years old and retiring off the giant gold chest in your bedroom that has your whole hoard, it's not worth it.
How does that even work? Like, how do you, like... Is gold really appreciating in value over time?
The
like
idea is that gold is like the standard of currency.
Is that just because it's easy to, it's rare and easy to trade?
It's a very pretty rare metal that only forms when stars explode. Uh-huh. And so it's shiny and gold.
When
and
stars explode.
That's so weird.
Is that how it forms?
Yeah. Only through supernovas does gold
I always thought that the pirates had like gold chests and had all their money in it, but like all they have is bitcoins now. I don't understand.
All the
pirates have bitcoin.
Yeah. Well, they just got big servers on their ships. Why are they still on ships? Just purely because they love it.
I thought you meant the guy. I thought you meant like the old dude in his bedroom. They locked in there.
No.
People like gold because it's used with shit. Like electronics use gold.
Oh, yeah.
Jewelry uses gold and stuff like that. Mm. But they don't actually use that much gold.
Mm-hmm.
So the value of gold is just because people keep buying it. It's not necessarily because it is that valuable.
And it's finite too. Like there's not infinite gold.
Yeah.
Right. So
I asked my parents for gold for Christmas one year and they said no.
So you know you're getting really spoiled.
Hey Toby, what do you want for Christmas?
I've already got everything. Just give me some gold.
No, Toby, we're just platinum this year, okay? We're all out of gold.
My weight in gold.
I wanted to start collecting a little bullion collection because you know me, I love collecting shit. I've always loved collecting shit. And I was like, well, the thing about collecting like gold and silver is it keeps its value and you get this cool thing.
This cool shiny little
thing. You get this shiny little thing and you're like, oh, that's cool. And then you put it in a safe and never look at it and then sell it in 20 years.
Mm. Mm. Sorry, Hugo. I don't really have anything to say. I was just saying maybe you should collect some common sense. That's all.
Yeah, that'd be good.
That was the only thought that was in my mind the entire time you were saying that.
That's fair.
It's weird that we attribute worth shit that intrinsically has no value. Like, we went from the barter system, like,
just the human experience.
Oh yeah, I'll have your fucking youngest daughter for like three goats, and then the guy was like, I bet, bro, three goats.
I can make another one.
My daughter has no value.
Exactly.
Sure.
It's like three goats. I can feed like two sons and make another daughter.
There we go.
With three goats, and you know, but you know, it was stuff that actually mattered. But then it was like, ooh, I see a shiny stone, new currency, and then everyone was like, ooh. shiny stone,
I need it.
And then the Romans were like, bruh, coins, how about we mint coins? And then everyone was like, ooh.
Ooh.
and then America came along, they were like, yo, like, fuck the British pound, fuck sterling, like, how about we do IOU notes made out of paper so that when we win the revolution, you guys get money. And everyone was like,
it's crazy.
Wow, still
fuck
just
the British.
And then America was like, okay, I know that these are all vouchers for something that we have, but what if hypothetically we stopped giving a shit about them actually having value and just printed more?
Yeah. Yes. And now
we don't actually have it. We don't. It's not.
And now it's, who cares about paper? Who cares about shit that you can physically touch that means nothing to you? It's all about bits and bytes and code on a fucking machine that didn't exist 30 years ago.
Just
and that's what's
gold.
Going to, that's what's going to hold the value.
And then you see a picture of a dog and you're like,
dog coin.
Dog coin.
To the moon.
Moon. Dog.
Rocket.
Where all my money go?
He's got a trusting little face.
How can you not sink fucking $30,000 into Dogecoin, you fucking idiots? You're missing out on so much money. Buy Dogecoin at 50 cents and then when it dips down to 2 cents, then
right. Sell it.
Buy high, sell low. That's
buy high, sell low.
Surely
you want to do.
Surely Matt has a bit of Robert De Niro in Dogecoin.
I mean, when it first came out, I mined a bunch of it back in like 2014. Yeah. It was like fucking worthless, and
that's
I had this
crazy.
That's crazy.
I had like this little milk crate that I built like a PC on.
Yeah,
and old graphics cards. So I threw
remember
it.
That setup. It was what? So jank,
dude. It worked
you
though.
A picture of it. It looked like something out of a mad scientist.
It looks like the biggest fire hazard.
A big tube to cool it, didn't you? Like a big
I took like a dryer. Okay, so I had the computer on an egg crate, right? And then I took like this clear case I made out of like plexiglass, and I took like dryer ductwork into the side and then like out the top the vent out heat.
This kind of
just like fucking air going through, and my parents were like, yeah, that's fine, that's normal, as long as it's not heating up the house, I guess we're okay with
this.
It
is kind of fucking
looks like a fire hazard.
It's MacGyvered a Dogecoin generator.
That's lit though.
It was fucking
how many were you like mining, like how, like back then how hard was it to mine them?
Oh, it's so easy. I think I got like at least six figures worth in only like a couple of months.
That's crazy,
because I had a dedicated video card set back.
Holy shit.
Wait,
that's
so
nuts.
You built this with the intention of mining Dogecoin? It wasn't like Bitcoin?
Yeah, only Dogecoin.
You're like, oh, they'll do that.
Yeah, I just thought it was funny. So, I had a spare graphics
that's
card.
So
I was like, fuck it.
Was that back in like the early days of Doge?
Yeah, back when
it
first came
like
out.
Really, really early.
Right, right.
Shit.
But that,
who's laughing now, though? Who's laughing now?
Yeah, exactly.
did you sell a lot of it, or are you still
holding it? No, I'm still holding on it.
Good, man. Hold until
I already
it
held
a
like 8 years. What's another 8
hold
years?
Hold until, once it hits a dollar, then bam.
Ah, man, $10.
$10 on Doge.
That'll be a Dogecoin millionaire.
Bro, how about when it hits a dollar, if it ever hits a dollar, you sell like maybe,
that's like in a week.
You know, you sell like maybe
like 10%, and
like
start slowly,
like a third, and then you recoup. And then if it ever dips again, then you can buy.
Reinvest.
You reinvest.
Yeah, not a bad idea.
Yeah,
or you could just like, you know, use the Doge to buy Bitcoin or buy something else, I guess.
Or buy something like useful, like real money.
That's kind of cringe.
They hate me for saying that. Oh no.
That's insane.
Wait, so you don't have a machine running now getting you more?
No,
Doge.
You can't. It's not worth mining nowadays.
How does the mining process work? Like, what do they look like on the computer?
So it's like a little command prompt thing. It's just
programs,
like, yeah, it just tells like how fast you're mining at it. Like
it opened up a RuneScape client, and then like your little character goes up to like the Doge ore, and then it starts mining.
That,
and then
that
only
surely
you,
has to be the future.
And then only if you have 99 mining, it'll take an hour to mine a Dogecoin. But you have to be careful about the PKers and the Venezuelans, because they're going to be coming after you.
That's like that game. What's the one where everything in the game has like actual monetary value?
Illyria or
something like
some
that.
Shit.
But,
oh, yeah, yeah.
But like everything has monetary value. It's just that everything takes fucking ages to actually like gather if you don't dump a bunch of money into it to get the best gear.
That'll be
the
massive,
one with
I
like
think,
the spaceships or some shit.
Mm.
Star Citizen or something like that.
Star Citizen.
I don't know what that is, but I'm pretty sure it's.
Didn't it secure like it was like. It was in the tens, if not the hundreds of millions of funding. It was just like the most anticipated, like, fucking GoFundMe Kickstarter project. Yeah. I even fucking fell for it back in fucking 2012, 2013. I was like, I want my own spaceship. This game looks sick. And I remember talking to my friends being like, yo, you see this game, Star Citizen? It's like, you could do anything you want. You go to a space station, you could order whatever you want. You get a hot dog. You could get a burger from a space station. You could do space anything you want. And they were looking at me. They were like, you're fucking full of shit. You get too hyped over games. And then Cube World fucking came out and
no one took you seriously.
Yeah, nobody takes you seriously anymore.
I remember seeing the early days of Star Citizen and being hyped for it too.
Exactly. Yeah,
I bought it as well.
Yeah, but now it's like, okay, if I want to play, like, this is, I've just made an investment so that in 20 fucking years, Star Citizen, how much is it? How much is it generated? How much?
$2 million?
Way more than this. Way more than it was. Look up the funding of Star Citizen. Look how much money that they've accrued over the last 10 years.
It was all crowdfunded?
That's insane.
It was mostly crowdfunded because they offered like giant fleets and ships and other shit.
It's been out for a while, no?
Been in like fucking beta pre-alpha for like 2 years, and it was alpha, and then it was in beta.
It's just such a ambitious project.
Well, the scope
that they're
is...
like, oh, it's gonna be finished eventually.
Yeah,
but it'll be in fucking 50 years when all the stuff they were doing is now just done by everyone else.
Yeah, that's the future, man. That's the future. Everything will just be taken care of by machines, and we'll just spend all our time playing games.
Yeah, that'll actually be
and arguing on social media,
pretending to have jobs in games, and arguing on social media, just using the money that you make in game to pay rent, buy food, then get back in the game. Keep cutting down trees for coin.
It would be pretty sick, a game like that. Like a game like RuneScape, but you just sell all your shit for real life money.
So dystopian.
That'd be awful. That'd be so awful.
It'd be pretty cool, like as a little side hustle.
Well, yeah, but then no one would go outside and do anything.
Imagine like you're like a 45-year-old man. You know, you've rounded out quite well. Yeah. You've made a nice life yourself. You've actually, you know, learned to enjoy all of the things that life has to offer by 45. You know?
Yeah.
Lived a very fulfilling life. Your fucking 13-year-old son, all he's doing is on the computer playing fucking RuneScape. He's making so much money, but he's doing fucking nothing. What do you say to him?
Fucking keep making your bags.
That's exactly like me at that age, except he's getting paid for it.
Exactly. It's like the same shit. Like when I started doing even when I first started doing anything under the name Swagger Souls, like on Twitch, like years before I did YouTube. Like, you know, I'd keep my fucking, you know, living with my dad to keep him up because I'm fucking, you know, talking shit and fucking playing the piano. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And he'd get pissed off at me. He'd be like, you know, you keep me up. Like, you're not, like, what the fuck are you even doing? He's like, look, if you're going to fucking be on the computer all the time, then find a way to make some fucking money at the very least. And then I was like, okay. And then I did. And now he can't, now he can't say anything. He can't say anything.
Yeah.
Love you, Dad.
Yeah. I mean, I could say the same thing. Like my parents told me to get off the computer all the time. I'm like, you're wasting your time. But then I still look back and think like, well, they were kind of right.
My parents were opposite.
I made it work for myself, but like definitely could have used a bit more outside time for sure. But you know, a bit of a balance perhaps.
Yeah. My parents were the opposite. My dad was a gamer. He played RuneScape and stuff.
Well, that's cool though. Yeah. You're bonding.
Your dad ever max?
No.
What a fucking casual.
Nah, yeah. He was a bit of a casual,
Dads are always like that though.
Yeah.
Like, doesn't your dad loves Age of Empires too, right?
Yeah.
But he still sucks at it.
Dude, it was so insane. This was because when we got really into AoE, when we were like going to Ryan's LAN setup, Manager Ryan had this massive LAN setup, like six fucking eight computers, and we'd all go over, we'd smoke dabs. This was like 2 years ago. We were making dabs out of fucking butane, and we'd smoke these fucking homemade dabs, which were awful for us. We'd get high out of our minds, and then we'd play Age of Empires 2. And I grinded that shit with everybody for like, it went for like a month. It was like
beautiful.
A full-on month, and it was awesome. And then I remember like thinking to my dad, like thinking back, every time I'd get home from school or every time I'd, you know, do anything, get home from work, he would just be sitting there playing AoE, doing his thing. I'd hear the do-do, like fucking all the time.
That's
mad. All he played. He played no other games.
I feel like gamer dads generally just play one game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or one franchise and nothing else.
Age of Empires is so good, though. I could play it.
Dude.
If I had one game to play with the rest of my life, it might be that. Like, it's just that good.
Yeah, I remember when I visited home, over Christmas, I remember talking to my dad because he was just playing AOE, and I was like, Dad, I've been getting so into AOE. I've been playing the shit out of Age of Empires. Like, yeah. I want to verse you. I want to see if you can kick my ass. He was like, yeah, I'll kick your ass. And then, like, I went up in my room. We connected. I made him a Steam account. He used his full fucking name for it, like a retard. I said, Dad, you have to delete this account and make another one. Yeah. He's like, okay. Made another one. And then I hopped on AOE, and I fucking floored him. He was doing, like, no
fucking
strength.
Fucking dog
doing
shit.
Nothing.
Just rush him early game.
I remember playing for, like, 10 years.
What's story? I remember asking him. I was like, you've been playing this game for, like, 15 years. And I was like, how am I better than this? You guys? He goes, oh, I only play against the machines on very easy. He's like, I don't like.
He just loves dominating.
Yeah. Just, you know, easy AI. He likes to do whatever he does. But I remember he forfeited. It was, like, 20 minutes into the game, and I go downstairs. I'm like, what are you doing?
He's crying.
Got farms everywhere. There's no consistency.
Fucking just, yeah.
That's so funny.
Only this is a very easy AI. It's like, another win for me.
Yeah, well, whatever makes him happy. He moved on to like War Thunder and all the World War II war games and shit.
Did you make him quit that game forever then by beating him?
No, I think genuinely, Matt, I think genuinely after like fucking 15 years of sustained play, he was like, I need to do something else. He played a Star Trek game for like 3 years and then he moved on. My dad is...
Your dad's a nerd.
He's autistic about Star Trek, dude. He's so, like, any time that I visit, he'll be watching just reruns of Star Trek. Whenever I ask him for life advice, he'll say, well, this reminds me of that
Spock
one Star Trek
said.
Episode. You know, Spock once said that you could do everything right but still lose. And I was like, well, that's like well written, but also like that's from Star Trek. You know what he does every Christmas? You know, because whenever I'd be with him, we'd set up a giant Christmas tree. During Christmas, a real tree decorated and everything. And now with, you know, his kids like moved out and everywhere or whatever, he fucking makes a Star Trek Christmas tree that he brings out of the basement.
It's a little
Christmas tree and it has all the Star Trek shit on it.
Does he have the big ship like on the top?
Yeah, what's at the top? What's the star?
The top? I think it's like a... It's like one of those cones with like, you know, where the star would be, except instead of the star, it's like the actual logo of Star Trek, like a little fucking weird
beautiful
A-looking thing. So
do you sing like Star Trek carols?
Do you ask him? He's probably learning Klingon
carols.
I don't think he's ever been that fucking autistic where he'd learn Klingon, but he's definitely a nerd. But I love him.
Nice.
I love him. He's got me into
That's
science.
Good stuff.
I feel like we'll have our own version of that we're clinging on to when we're fucking
Klingoning.
Old.
Yeah.
You know, like our own nostalgic thing that
what do you think that would be? What do you think the most, like SpongeBob?
I'm going to be like cramming all the shit I used to watch as a kid down my kid's throat for sure.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
yo,
watch all these
100%.
Old Disney films, watch SpongeBob, watch this.
Yeah.
Your modern cartoons are trash.
It's exactly what it is.
It's so true.
I'm going to show my kids, I'm going to say watch SpongeBob, but only on the DVDs that I fucking have. Yep. I'm like season 10 after season 10, don't watch it. Have any of you ever watched SpongeBob season 10 or after?
Dude, it's
no,
so.
But we know
it's
what like, you think of it.
Have I said this before? Dude, I just
it's
can't
so
get over
weird.
I can't get over the one time that I watched it with my friends. To be fair, I was also either on acid or really, really high, but I had watched it and I couldn't fucking believe what I was seeing.
Does SpongeBob still sound like SpongeBob now that the voice actor's dead?
No, the voice actor's
voice
like dead.
He just moved on, didn't he?
No, he's still around, I think.
I don't think he's doing the voice anymore.
You don't think Tom Kenny's doing SpongeBob?
No,
one of the SpongeBob voice actors die?
No,
oh, that's a show creator.
That's a show creator. Stephen Hellenberg.
No, right. Recipes. Maybe I'm wrong.
He died.
Never mind.
Yeah.
No, it's just
now catered to a new Zoomer audience.
Awful.
It's just memes.
Hey, Patrick.
Hey, Patrick.
See this meme?
Squidward's kind of sus.
Hey, Patrick, what's 9 plus 10?
21. 21.
Oh,
my God.
Hey, Patrick, I'm on TikTok. I'm so famous.
SpongeBob. That's offensive.
SpongeBob. You're going to get canceled on Twitter again.
Canceled by Bikini Bottom. Oh, my God.
Jeez.
Fucking... trying to go into driving lessons, fucking just self-driving cars and Bikini Bottom now.
Yeah,
it's all modern.
I would, incredible. I would love to see Twitter cancel SpongeBob over sexual assault allegations, just as a joke.
as a joke. It'll happen.
It's just saying like,
Sandy Cheeks, my truth.
Yeah, it's like Sandy Cheeks, slit longer. Fucking SpongeBob coming out being like, I changed.
This was many years ago.
He's got like a sad laugh.
At the time, I thought my relations with Sandy would be purely consensual.
I don't need it.
Oh my god.
That was what the episode was actually about. He was just so dry for pussy. SpongeBob was in the fucking
book. I don't need it. I need it. What they Jesus.
That's when they cut it out.
That's fucking, this is awful, but no, it's also hilarious. Pretty great.
It's hilarious. Think about it.
Dude, SpongeBob. Fucking the rapist.
Sounds like it's a Meat Canyon like animation.
That does sound like a Meat Canyon animation, dude.
I love when people recommend the old movies and they're like, they gotta preface it with, now like, this stuff would not hold up. Now, like it's
crazy.
Horribly offensive, yeah. But also the movie is great.
Yeah,
it's like it's really sexist, really transphobic, really just
funny.
Aggressive, but great movie.
That's the thing. A lot of people are like shit from the 90s. They're like, oh fucked. Yeah. Well, let's just preface this by saying, yeah, you'll probably cry if you're on Twitter all the time and you watch this movie.
Yeah.
I miss the good old days where when you didn't like a movie, you turn it off. Mm. And you didn't have to fucking tell anybody how much you hate the movie and that you're going to dox the creator.
Yeah, I miss the good old days when people knew that their opinion was invalid and didn't matter.
Yeah. People keep it to themselves most of the time.
Yeah, because no one gives a shit.
No one cares. Alone.
Oh, shit.
Alone.
What was the best episode of SpongeBob? What's the most memorable episode of SpongeBob for you guys?
Mm. Oh shit!
Mine's the caveman one. That's one I remember the most.
I like the one where they went to space on Sandy's rocket. I'm pretty sure that was an episode. Was it, or was that a fucking fever dream that
it was? But they just landed in Bikini Bottom.
Exactly.
They didn't actually
leave. Yeah. Yeah. Didn't they land like the California or something?
The pizza one, the Krusty Krab pizza.
That's
a good one. The Magic Con show is a good
remember
one.
Remember the scary one where he goes to like that bus stop?
Yeah.
And it was a hash slinging slash or something.
Is it Rock Bottom? Oh, is it Rock Bottom? He's down bad.
Yeah, Rock Bottom was good. Mm. Fucking, it was the very first original one where Squidward eats the fork and he's going, like that, back and forth.
SpongeBob
and
episode
you see
tearless.
You see like the outside of his fucking throat is like there's a fork in his throat. It's going up and
so
down.
So good, so good.
Dude, I remember that. I fucking first saw that. I was dry heaving.
Squidward tortellini.
So yeah, dude. It was when he had the purebred snail.
Oh, so good.
It was just a complete, like, think of trying to invent a show like SpongeBob. Like, what a wild
how the fuck
thing.
Do you
character
do
design
that?
Crazy.
Yeah.
Ideas crazy.
Mm. Dude, I'm so surprised that they never did an episode where SpongeBob got braces or something.
Mm.
Like,
perfect teeth, yeah.
Yeah, because he had, like, you know, what the two-buck teeth.
It
like,
probably wouldn't look very good if he got braces. They would just bring them both together and he just have, like, a sandy cheek situation.
Well, exactly. It's like, if that happened, and it's like, you know, it's like, in the end, like, he didn't need the braces and he should accept who he is.
We'll probably see that.
SpongeBob would just, like, that's a great set of pearly white chompers on him. Just fucking
a great
perfect smile.
Is that one of the episodes where he's like normal? He's like, hi, I'm normal.
Yeah. Normal Bob.
Yeah.
Hi, how are you?
Yeah.
Hi, how are you?
Oh my god, we're literally boomers. We're literally just reminiscing over
old cartoons.
Old cartoons.
Yeah. I could bust it out to old SpongeBob.
Yeah.
It's great. It's one of the best shows. You really don't appreciate it when you're a kid as much as you do when you're older, I think.
Do you think SpongeBob was your favorite cartoon?
I really like Jimmy Neutron. Mm. I really like Fairly Odd Parents.
Oh, Fairly Odd Parents was good.
I like the old Nick shit that I watched like growing up. Have you heard of Robot Jones?
No.
Like,
what was the monster one?
Angry Beavers, Cat Dog.
Ah, Real Monsters was that one. They had the dude with the hairy pits that held the eyeballs.
Oh, yeah. The Foster's something.
Foster's Home.
No, Foster's Home. Was
Real Monsters was always on too late. Like, I could never watch it. I'd always, like, catch a glimpse of it,
it's
and then 9
p.m.,
I had to go to bed.
10 p.m.
Yeah.
The Grim Tales of
Nick
Bill and Mandy,
dark.
Or whatever it's called.
That was so good.
Courage the Cowardly Dog was always, like, a weird fever dream.
Don't be afraid of the dark, or afraid of the dark, or something like that. Do you remember that?
What's that?
I think it was called Afraid of the Dark, but it was this fucking I it's hard to explain.
He's sweating just thinking about
my
it.
My brain is trying to suppress the memories. It was like basically like live action horror stuff that they play in October.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
Was it? There's that YouTube series that don't be. What was it that of those like?
Oh, don't hug me, I'm scared.
Don't hug me, I'm scared. Yeah, kind of like what you're talking about.
No, it was a completely different thing. Oh, it was just like, it was back in like 2000.
I wish they would just air that shit on.
I think it was like 2003, I think.
Fuck.
Yep, cartoons. Nothing like that feeling of a Saturday morning. You get your cereal.
Yeah,
the cartoons are on.
The biggest. Got nothing to worry about your kid. The biggest bowl in the house. Mm-hmm. You put cereal in it.
Oh, the fucking shit.
You just eat the whole fucking box of cereal.
I feel like all kids from that generation had the same childhood. It was just like every weekend, you go to school a week, then on the weekends you sit down and you watch cartoons.
Every single child.
And tune out.
In every culture.
And tune out.
Everyone had a TV.
No difference.
Everyone had a TV. They all sat down on Saturday with the cereal in their little onesie, and they'd sit down and they'd watch the TV and try to tune out the sound of their parents fighting and about to have a divorce.
Yeah.
Mm. Every single child.
That's how my parents love starting their Saturday mornings. It's like, all right, let's get into it.
Let's hash this out.
What are we doing? We fist fighting? Come on. Let's fuck it up. Anyway, just longing for the past, aren't we?
Yeah.
Dude.
Take us back.
Reminiscent.
I've been having some like weird shit. I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's like I'm just particularly stressed out like the last couple of weeks or whatever. But like, I'll just be sitting doing something and then like... like flashback, super hyper realistic, vivid flashback of me and my youth doing something.
Whoa.
Sometimes it's me doing something embarrassing or saying something that was stupid.
It's like a shit, that's
and
a
then,
raven.
And then it's like, yeah, right? I have a fucking flashback.
That's so swagger.
And then it's just like, it's just like I feel the guilt and I feel the shame of like shit that I like that happened like 20 years ago.
Yeah.
Like and it's weird. And then other times like
I can't believe I shit my pants as a baby. Oh my god, so fucking
I shat
stupid.
All up my bag. So no, but it's like I'll have like a fucking flashback and everything will flood back. And it could even just be like normal shit, just me as a kid, like happy doing whatever the fuck. And I'll be like, wow, I wish I could just regress. I wish I could just be a kid again.
Yeah.
With fucking nothing to worry about.
Mm. Well,
it is crazy.
You can be a kid again.
Yeah. You just got to drink from the fountain of youth.
That's right.
You just have to find it.
It's gonna find it.
Yeah.
It's at my place. I'll come over sometime.
Shit, no way.
You know how David Dobrik's got that fountain in his place. That
fountain
pumps out fucking
youth?
Whatever the fuck.
Cool. The it's punch.
Yeah, I got that, but
something
it's,
fruit punch.
It's the blood of his friends.
It's the tears of children. Yeah. It's the fountain of youth.
Yeah. Is that what the fountain of youth is?
That's how I keep myself looking so young.
Oh.
And not weathered at all.
Oh, I see.
These bags don't lie.
Anyway, maybe we'll get back to the past someday. Maybe when our cycle completes, we'll find ourselves back in the body of a young child.
Do you reckon you guys would time travel if you had the option to go back in time, but you can't go back to like prison?
You go back for,
go back, but you can't like...
Yeah.
Wait, so you go back and you're a kid again?
Yeah.
Or you go back as a man in a kid's world?
No, you go back into a period of time that you've lived through.
Yeah, but like,
but you can't.
Do you see yourself?
Do you have
memories? Are you yourself?
No.
Do you like? Or is it like an Adam Sandler or like a?
Nope. You just go back to that point. No memory of like what you have now. You just go back.
No.
To
the point. Fuck
no.
That's kind of pointless, then, right?
Is it?
Well, how would you even know?
Unless you're retaining your knowledge, then it's basically just like, you know, it's not like you're. It's not even like you would make different choices.
It would just be an endless cycle, too.
Yeah.
Maybe that's just what happens. Yeah. We're just constantly on repeat.
That would
fucking We've done this
suck.
Show like 1,000 times
that
already.
Would suck dick, dude.
It's doomed to be
it's
on
like
the same
you die
track.
And it's born, and it's like for like the first month of you living is like a fucking stupid baby that can't communicate. Like you're like, I remember this. I remember this. I remember this.
Oh god.
And then you like lose a memory. It's
fucked.
Just like you're back. You're like, dude, doing this over once sucks enough. It's also really good, but like...
But you wouldn't remember doing it
You wouldn't remember it.
And
exactly, every once in a
like,
while...
I would hate, you know, come on.
You could have done this exact show and said that exact line like 200 times already,
shit.
Not knowing.
That's exactly that's what reality is. And then every generation is one person who's a catalyst that changes the course of history and puts us on a different path.
Dude.
Big words.
Yeah.
If I feel like if I was going back in time to any point of time before I started doing YouTube with all the knowledge that I currently have, I'd fuck it all up.
Yeah, same.
I'd fuck it.
Yeah.
You have to be the right. Everything. You have to be the right place at the right time for the right stuff to happen. Meet the right people.
You always feel like you're running late.
Yeah, dude.
Oh, there's that guy I need to talk to to make that thing happen. Oh, he's gone.
Yeah, it's like, oh, well, I can't.
Very
it's
true.
Fucked. It's like, you know, if I didn't log on that fucking surf server that Matt was on, like, I wouldn't be
But
here.
You'd Just buy a bunch of crypto early on, it'd be fine.
Yeah, exactly. All right, I'm spending all my allowance. Mom, Dad, the quarters, the pennies, it's all going into Bitcoin. Where's Bitcoin?
Mom, Dad,
fuck you. You'll see in 10 years.
This might sound ridiculous, but I want you to pay my allowance in digital gold.
Gold. Oh, God.
Anyway, I hope you're enjoying reliving your hellish cycle. Over and over and over again.
Yeah.
This has been the
by
Misfits
listening
podcast.
To the Misfits podcast.
Wake up, sheeple.
That's right. Every week is the same. Welcome back. You're stuck.
This is a loop.
You're being looped.
Break it. This is your opportunity.
Break out of the cycle. Do something different. Punch a wall. Do a little dance.
Pinch yourself.
Murder
Scream
someone.
At the top of your lungs.
Yep.
Flash someone.
You know, live a little.
Give someone a peep show for
$2. Change the course of your history. Do some weird shit.
Get into a car crash.
Maybe not that one.
Yeah, oh,
maybe
if you do survive it, make sure you kill no other people.
Be heroic with it, you know? At least do a cool flip.
Yeah.
With a missing
cool flip.
We'll see you next week. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.